Okay guys, the result is completed. So go to result. Then see the simulation here. See the impact drop from the top on this concrete and this damage, compressive damage there. Tensile damage and other like equivalent plastic strain is there. So this data is up to you. Just find those required if you see, for example, this covalent plastic strain, or let me change this compressive damage. Then you can plot this output request. Go to here, create XY data, or in go to here, tool XY data, then create, or here in this. Create here XY data, then by default it may be ODP history output. You can change field output or history output, whatever you can choose. So damage dissipation energy for the whole model is looks like this, with that of step time from 0 up to this 0.2. The dissipation energy, damage dissipation energies look like this. Other artificial energy or what, plastic dissipation also plotted like this. Original creep, this 0 actually. See this creep, because we have no data regarding to this, it will be zero. The other, go to here in order to draw this ODP field output. For example, to draw one of the parameters from this, the compressive damage, check this, then go to here element set or element label, then assembly on beam, then let do one thing first. Dismiss this window, then go to tool query, then element, then select one element here. Let's plot in XY and at the center, of length, for example, here around here. Select one node here. So save this number 14,016 is there. Let's copy this one. Then go to air field outputs. And go to damage, select this, check this box, damage, compressive damage, then element node, select this element label, then part instance instead of assembly, just this beam, then write that number, this number that is the element selected at this point, then plot. So the graph looks like this, damage That's compressive damage. If you want to another tensile damage, plot this way. For that specific node, for this node, you can go to this equivalent plastic strain, for example. Plot. Then it looks like plastic strain from 0 up to 0.02 with time. The graph is looks like this. Okay, once after you examine the result on this reinforcement concrete, lead to another part without reinforcement. This assembly you have, you go to here. Here we have reinforcement. Let's remove this reinforcement. Let's copy this model. Copy. Then rename this model too. Then go to assembly instance. Then delete all reinforcement except that of. Then this will left only concrete and the impactor. Then this shear bar. Delete and this pop. Rebar, then here one thing is left. Delete. Then we have this. You go to create job. Let without. Reinforcement continue. Then this parallelization increase the multiple processor and select this double analysis. Okay, then go to here and submit the result. Okay, it says it was constraint one without is applied the region that has been deleted or removed it says. So go to this interaction constraint one, it's embedded those reinforcement it inside the concrete, but for this model we have no reinforcement, so delays this. We don't need any constraint regarding to that reinforcement, so delete this embedded rigid constraint. Then go to job and submit. It's submitted. So after some time it will complete. Okay, the result is completed. So go to result. And see those output damage, compressive damage, and tensile damage, and compare this value with the previous one. So if you let create two window here, So in separate video, go to select this when this window active. Then this damage, compressive damage there, and click here, then compressive damage. So see the difference here. At the same running time, this for example one. One or this tensile damage, and for this also tensile damage, go to this plot. Damage dissipation energy. Okay, this. Okay, I think I selected one node. This damage, tensile damage there, or compressive damage. It this one is in step things we have 200 selected frame or increase 200 increment. So let's put on mid 100, and similarly for this, click on this. This window will active then. Then choose 100 is similar increment. So if see the variation, it at 1 and this much value, this I think similar. Let's change this one. This one is, let's go to job this model one, okay, results. Then click here and go to visualization. It's model one, okay. I'm mistaken here. Let's change this one, model two, and go to result. So here compressive damage, and choose this 100. Okay, so clearly we can see the different, we have different value. The top is similar maximum compressive damage value, but at the bottom it will decrease the value, because damage simply by minimum force will damage when there is no reinforcement inside the concrete. This minimum value as compared to this one. So go to here, create XY data, then ODP field output. Let history outputs and see damage dissipation energy. Same plot. This for the concrete without reinforcement. Then go to history output and plot damage dissipation energy. If you plot the data with one graph, clearly you can see the variation. To do this, go to this XY data. Let's delete this one. I think this temp is for this one, and this one is then copy this data to other plotting software. This value then paste on this either Origin software, any software you can use, or MATLAB, whatever, it's up to you. And let's add this data, copy this all. And paste here. So the time or step time is the same. The energy is different. So go to insert and this line graph. Let's do, let's deselect this one, click here, then create add, then with reinforcement. X value, just choose this one. And Y values. Add and choose second graph. Okay, the graphs looks like this synergy this time. One is for this one is without reinforcement, and this is with reinforcement. So the dissipation energy required to damage plasticity or damage compressive, it's different. So this is the aim of today's video. Please subscribe the channel to get more about this Savako software application and other simulation for the future. Please subscribe, like and share the video. Thank you for watching.